Hello guys and welcome back to my channel Civil Construction and Tutor. And in this video I will show you how to model a staircase in our for a residential building using ETABS. So the very first thing I will do is to assign a reference plane which will act as the mid landing level. So for this, let us go to add or modify grids. So basically I am fixing the mid landing level. Modify or show grid system, go to reference plane. And basically the mid landing will be at the mid height of the story height, and for our building the story height is 3 meter. That means the mid landing will be provided at 1.5 meter. Okay, so here you can see there is no mid landing till now. So after clicking OK, you will see a new grid, and this is the plan view of the reference plane at z is equal to 1.5 meter. So the very first thing is done, that is assigning the reference plane. Now we have to fix the exact dimension or exact position of the flight and the landing. So for this we'll use our architectural drawing. So this is our architectural drawing, and this is the position of the staircase, and it is the staircase is exactly divided into two halves of this void, so it becomes more easier to model in ETABS. We'll use the snap command of ETABS to locate this point. So we have already, let us go to the upper story. So we have already provided it a void. So now you can see for this beam we are not shown the midpoint. For this you have to go to right click and then use snap option and tick this line ends and midpoints. Okay, apply, close. Now you can see a midpoint, we can locate the midpoint, so it will be much more easier to work. We have to provide a grid at this point which will represent the mid length of the staircase, and also a grid line at this point which will fix the length or dimension of the landing. For now the stair is to be provided at this mid half, so we can easily provide a grid considering the coordinate which is shown here. We have to provide at this direction, that is y direction, so the value is 10.7. so we'll provide a new grid, modify or show grid along y axis at 10.7. so right, modify, add, considering this as display grid data as ordinate, so add 10.7. okay, so a grid has been provided along y axis. Similarly for mid landing we have to provide grid along this direction, so the distance is to be provided as from this point we have to provide at a 1 meter towards left. That means the value is 8.39, that will be 7.39. edit, modify grids, modify our show grid system, and let us add 7.39 considering the landing as 1 meter. So 7.39. okay, so the grid has been formed. So considering the mid landing we should provide another grid at this point as well. So add or modify, modify our show grid system, and the grid at this point will be y is equal to 9.6. add 9.6. okay, so grid has been added. So now we can draw or model the staircase easily. Okay, but before that we have to assign section properties for the slab of staircase. So add new property, stairs, and we have already assigned material as M20, so we'll be providing M20 for grade of concrete for the stairs. It will be cell thin, and generally it is provided as 150. Type will be slab. Okay, now we'll model the staircase. So you have to use this command, that is draw floor or wall. So we'll start with stairs. So we'll start from base, that is z is equal to 0. And so basically, remember, I'll model stair for the first floor and then I'll replicate it to the other floor where I am interested. So for now, I'll keep this as one story. And you can either draw inclined flight and horizontal slab respectively separately, or you can draw as a whole, as a single block. Okay, I'll draw separately, that is inclined slab and the horizontal slab. So I'll start with this point, z is equal to 0, straight line. Now this is the inclined slab that will go to the mid landing. So z is equal to 1.5, and it will come back to z is equal to 0. So you can see here the inclined slab has been, or the inclined flight has been drawn. Now at z is equal to 1.5, we'll have a horizontal slab. You can directly use this command. So horizontal slab has been drawn, and now go to z is equal to 1.5, and this will go to z is equal to 3. So starting through this point, go to z is equal to 3 and again come back to z is equal to 1.5. So here you can see our stair has been modeled. So you can either draw this as a single block, this horizontal slab, because at the end the ETAS will automatically mesh it, as we know that the finite element analysis meshing is done automatically. So either you can draw as a single block or you can draw this as a separate blocks. So steps or stairs has been modeled. Now we'll replicate this to the upper stories. So select, hit it, replicate, and it has to be replicated for story 1, story 2 only, because there won't be stair in the story 3 as there is no any void. Go to story, select story 1 and story 2, apply. So here you can see that our staircase has been modeled. We have to assign fixed support at the base of the staircase. So select this, as this is already a fixed support. So for this, select and assign restraints and then provide fixed support. Okay. So fixed support has been provided. Now let us see in the extruded view. Let us see our staircase only. Select. So selected objects only. So this is our stair. I hope you are clear about modeling of the stair. Now let us apply load. So all objects. Get previous selection. The staircase has been selected. Now we'll assign load, that is dead load and the live load that will act on the staircase. Basically, the live load will consider the load of the step, that is riser, and you can say the steps and the floor finish. So assign cell loads uniform. Firstly, we'll provide floor finish, that is 1 kilonewton per meter square generally, and similarly we'll apply staircase load, which is the load of the steps, and we can calculate that. Generally it comes as 3 to 5 kilonewton per meter square, so I'll show you how to calculate it. This is the slab, this portion, and this is the steps. We have to assign the load of this portion, that is the triangular portion, as we have only modeled the slab. So we have to use the triangular formula to find the weight of this triangular portion. So here you can see we have been provided with riser as 17 and use the triangular formula. 25 as a unit weight of concrete times of 1 by 2 b into h, So width being a unit, so 25 into 0.5 into 1 meter into height of the staircase flight stair step, that is riser. So this is 17 centimeter. Converting this into meter, this comes as 0.17. So this is 2.125. So we have to assign dead load of steps as 2.125 kilonewton per meter square. So now for applying the staircase, we have to select only the flights, as the steps are to be provided in the steps only. So select all the steps, apply. So the dead load of the steps has been provided. And similarly again, select all the steps, select and will provide the dead load, sorry, live load. Properties, slab section, stairs, select, and now we'll apply live load of 3 kN per meter square for the residential building staircase. Apply. Okay. After modeling the staircase, during assigning the diaphragm, we should not consider the horizontal slab as a diaphragm element, because it, as we said, the diaphragm is a nearly horizontal system. But if we consider the floor level and the landing level, these aren't horizontal elements. So diaphragm is not assigned to the staircase or the landing slab. That's why staircase brings eccentricity in the building. So finally, the modeling and load assignment for the staircase for a residential building has been done. Now you can run this model and design the staircase. Thank you this much in this video. I hope I help you to understand how to model staircase in ETAPS. Thank you.